People have always been fascinated by exploring the deep ocean. On June 18, 2023, a special expedition took place to see the famous Titanic wreckage. Five people went down in a submersible called Titan, going about 3,810 meters below the surface. The submersible mysteriously disappeared, creating a tragic event and leaving many unanswered questions. In this video, we'll explore the mysterious vanishing of the Titan submersible and uncover the possible truth about what happened. First, we're going to take a look at what a submersible is and how it differs from a submarine. A submersible is an underwater craft that requires a surface vessel or platform for transportation and support, while submarines can operate independently. Additionally, submersibles are typically smaller with limited passenger capacity, while submarines are larger and can carry more crew weapons and supplies. Let's find out what the OceanGate Titan submersible is all about. Titan is a deep-sea diving vehicle created and operated by OceanGate Expeditions, an ocean exploration company founded in 2009. Their aim is to provide tourists with the opportunity to explore the depths of the ocean. Designed to carry up to five people, Titan can descend to a depth of 4,000 meters. According to OceanGate website, it has successfully undertaken trips to the Titanic wreck, located approximately 3,800 meters below the ocean's surface off Newfoundland, Canada, in 2021 and 2022. Weighing 9,525 kilograms, Titan can travel at a speed of 3 knots using electric thrusters. It is equipped with powerful LED lights, a sonar navigation system, high-end camera equipment, and has a single porthole. Titan features a life support system that can sustain 5 people for up to 96 hours. Its carbon fiber walls are 13 centimeters thick, and the vessel is capped with titanium domes at each end. Due to the high-risk nature of the experience, passengers are required to sign a liability waiver acknowledging the experimental nature of the vessel and the high risk involved, with the word death mentioned 3 times to emphasize the potential dangers. Inside, Titan is about the size of a minivan, measuring 6.7 meters in length. Passengers sit on the floor with their backs against a curved wall. The submersible has a single porthole through which passengers can view the underwater wreckage. There is also a basic toilet on board. To launch Titan, it is transported on a small platform, aboard a commercial ship, and then submerged several dozen meters below the surface. The vehicle is operated using a video game controller, and the OceanGate team on the surface sends navigation instructions via text messages to the pilot. So what happened to Titan's mission on June 18, 2023? It was the first mission of the year in which Titan died to explore the wreckage of historical Titanic, which sank in 1912. The opportunity cost each passenger aboard $250,000. Aboard the vessel were 5 individuals: Hamish Harding, a billionaire British adventurer; Shahzada Dawood, a British-Pakistani businessman; and his 19-year-old son Suleiman, who accompanied him on the journey; Paul Henry Narjolet, a French maritime expert; and Stockton Rush, the founder of OceanGate. On Friday, June 16, the Polar Prince, a Canadian icebreaker ship, departed from Newfoundland on towing the Titan submersible, which was on its way to explore the underwater resting place of the legendary ocean liner. On Sunday, June 18, at 8 a.m., Titan submerged. The Titan's connection to the outside world was maintained through a communication channel with Polar Prince. Every 15 minutes, the submersible would send a signal to the support ship, ensuring a lifeline between the deep sea and the surface. Just 1 hour and 45 minutes into the dive, the submersible suddenly lost contact with the support ship. As the scheduled return time before 4:30 p.m. came and went without any sign of the submersible, concern mounted, and the team aboard the Polar Prince decided to alert the U.S. Coast Guard. Thus began a multinational, multi-million-dollar search operation that lasted 5 days. The disappearance of the Titan submersible led to a large-scale operation to search and rescue the passengers. The main concern was finding out what happened to them. The search for the missing submersible continued for 5 days, and the U.S. Coast Guard reported the discovery of a debris field about 784 kilometers away from the Titanic wreckage. This discovery was made by a remotely operated vehicle in the area where the Titan was supposed to explore the sunken vessel. Following the distressing find of debris from the Titan submersible on the ocean floor, along with possible human remains, Rear Admiral John Mocker stated that the evidence pointed to a catastrophic implosion. 2 areas of debris were found, one containing the tail cone of the Titan and the other its landing frame, indicating that they separated after the vessel collapsed. Given the evidence and circumstances, it appears that Titan's fate was sealed by a catastrophic implosion. Now, let's try to understand what an implosion is and how it potentially contributed to this outcome. Implosion is a destructive process, where an object collapses inwardly, opposite to the outward expansion of an explosion. In the case of the Titan submersible, implosion occurred due to the extremely high hydrostatic pressure of the surrounding water. At the depth where the Titanic rests, the water pressure is about 5,600 pounds per square inch, nearly 400 times the pressure on the surface. As the submersible descended into the ocean, the force from the water pressure exceeded the strength of its hull, resulting in a violent implosion. The unique design of the Titan, which relied heavily on carbon fibers instead of traditional materials like steel or titanium, contributed to the vulnerability. Carbon fibers have the advantage of being lightweight, but their behavior under deep-sea conditions is not well understood, and they can suddenly crack or break. In early July 2023, videos were shared on TikTok and YouTube, claiming to contain a transcript or log of the final text message communications from OceanGate Expedition's Titan submersible. The unverified document suggests that it reveals the last words exchanged between someone on board the sub, presumably OceanGate CEO Stockton Rush, and the team aboard the mothership, the Polar Prince. This has sparked concerns, particularly because it implies that the passengers were aware of issues with the vessel approximately 19 minutes before it tragically imploded. According to the transcript, at 9:28 a.m., the Titan crew noticed an alarm from the RTM, real-time monitoring system. It was unanimously decided to abort their descent and initiate the ascent. However, the ascent took longer than expected, and by the time they provided their final update, the RTM displayed all red alerts. At 9:50 a.m., the Polar Prince reportedly communicated to the sub, "We're not receiving you. Please update." It continued, "We are unable to read you. We are moving to recovery coordinates. Report if you read." The transcript concludes at 9:57 a.m. with a final plea from the ship, "Please respond if you're able." These final messages clearly indicate that the RTM system was in full alarm due to hull integrity issues, and the crackling sounds were an unmistakable sign of carbon fiber layers moving and bending. At this point, it becomes apparent that the vessel imploded, resulting in the tragic loss of all five passengers. This breakdown in communication provides insight into the nature of the Titan's failure and the challenging timeline the passengers endured. It's essential to note that this transcript lacks official verification by any company representatives, and as such, its accuracy cannot be definitively confirmed. The unfortunate fate of the OceanGate Titan brings up important questions. What mistakes did OceanGate make that could have avoided this tragedy? And what does this mean for the future of underwater adventure tourism? OceanGate may have made several mistakes that could have contributed to the disappearance of the Titan submersible. It's unclear what caused the implosion, but experts have identified some concerning issues about Titan's safety that were evident before the trip. Firstly, the Titan submersible had an unconventional design, featuring two titanium domes connected by a 5-inch thick carbon fiber cylinder. Unlike typical deep-sea submersibles using stronger materials like steel or titanium, carbon fiber was chosen for its lighter weight and cost-effectiveness. However, OceanGate had received warnings about safety risks associated with carbon fiber. An ex-employee raised concerns about pressure cycling, where flaws in the hull could lead to tears under repeated pressure changes. OceanGate CEO, Stockton Rush, acknowledged breaking conventional rules but defended the choice based on engineering and logic. In December 2018, OceanGate stated that the Titan's successful 4,000-meter dive validated their innovative use of carbon fiber and titanium in its construction. Secondly, concerns about the early warning system were overlooked. OceanGate developed an advanced acoustic monitoring system to detect hull failures. However, former employee David Lockridge warned in 2018 that this system would provide only milliseconds of warning before a catastrophic implosion. He recommended non-destructive testing on the hull, but OceanGate didn't follow this advice, citing the hull's thickness. It's uncertain if these concerns were addressed, and OceanGate declined to comment on the matter when approached by the New York Times. Thirdly, OceanGate resisted requests to certify the submersible, and it's possible that the Titan never underwent strict safety testing, as the company argued against it in 2019. Journalist David Pogue, who boarded the Titan in 2022, mentioned signing a waiver stating the vessel lacked regulatory approval or certification. There's no evidence it has been certified since. Furthermore, David Lockridge's report revealed that the front viewport was certified to a depth much shallower than the Titanic's. The company's approach to certification was questioned by the Marine Technology Society in 2018. While OceanGate claimed it would meet industry certification standards, it seemed they hadn't adhered to those rules, potentially misleading the public. In a 2019 blog, OceanGate argued that not following these standards allowed for more innovation and cited operator error as the primary cause of accidents in marine and aviation settings. Lastly, OceanGate has experienced prior submersible issues. In 2021, a Titan trip encountered battery problems, necessitating manual attachment to the lifting platform. In 2022, journalist Pogue reported that the vessel became lost for hours, prompting OceanGate to shut off internet access during the incident. Pogue mentioned OceanGate's explanation for the internet shutdown, citing potential emergencies. He also noted the absence of an emergency location transmitter, ELT, on the craft. OceanGate has not responded to these claims when contacted by Insider. Experts also pointed out other potential mistakes, like the absence of a backup communication system and a lack of an automatic mechanism to bring the submersible to the surface in case of issues. The Titan submersible's disappearance has raised concerns in the underwater adventure tourism industry. Its impact is uncertain, but it has raised awareness of deep-sea exploration risks. This may lead to more precautions and safety advancements. In early September 2023, the U.S. government has filed a motion to halt an upcoming expedition aimed at retrieving historical artifacts from the sunken Titanic. Their reasoning is grounded in both a federal law and an international agreement that designate the shipwreck as a sacred resting place. This expedition is being spearheaded by RNS Titanic Inc., a Georgia-based company with salvage rights to this iconic shipwreck. RST has tentatively scheduled the expedition for May 2024, as indicated in a report submitted to the court in June. The U.S. contends that entering the fractured hull of the Titanic or altering or disturbing the wreck falls under the purview of federal law and their agreement with Britain. Among their concerns is the potential disturbance of artifacts and any human remains that might still be present. While this case has no connection to the Titan submersible tragedy, it does raise significant questions about access to the Titanic wreck. The disappearance of the Titan submersible during its Titanic expedition is a mystery, leaving the fate of the five on board unknown. This tragic event emphasizes the risks of deep-sea exploration and the importance of safety. However, the Titan submersible's legacy represents human bravery in exploring the unknown. While technology or unexpected discoveries may one day solve the mystery, for now, it stands as a poignant reminder of the mysterious depths beneath our ocean's surface. Thank you for watching.